Good morning. My name is Soumya. I am an assistant professor of St. Martin's Engineering College. Today I would like to explain you one concept in an operating system. So before that, I would like to tell the definition of an operating system. So operating system is nothing but it is the interface between a user and a computer hardware. So I would like to write the definition of this. The operating system is the interface between a user and a computer hardware. So here is the definition of an operating system. The operating system is the interface between user and a computer hardware. So here we are saying that OS, operating system, is the interface between a user and a computer hardware. So here, whenever a user wants to use the computer system, so here internally the operating system will be the interface to communicate with the hardware device. Okay, so it is nothing but operating system is nothing but it is the interface between user and a computer hardware. So next, coming to this, we can take one example of an operating system, like a general example which we know is like, I will tell the government is working as an operating system. So why I am using the word called government? Because we had a name called government. Based on this only all the customers or all the people will be working based on some rules and regulations of this government, right? So here the government is acting as an operating system where the people under this, as government is designing different schemes like scheme 1, scheme 2, like that we had different types of schemes, right? Not only the, we can say, we don't say the schemes, but coming to educational side, you have many structures of it. So where the government is going to decide on that. So now the government is acting as an operating system, based on that people work based on these schemes. Okay, so this is a general example which I can give for an operating system, where for this government is acting as an interface between the public and then based on its applications. Okay, so this is one example of an operating system. So why we go for an operating system? Why? Because operating system is trying to manage multiple things, like it is trying to manage resources, it is trying to manage the process, it is trying to manage the memory. So all these things are either the files, and it is trying to give a protection. So all these things are managed by an operating system. Okay, so here I would like to introduce the concepts of process states, and then the next we will discuss about a schedules. Okay, so first I would like to explain you about a process state. So this look like a general program is nothing but what? A program is nothing but it is a set of instructions. Set of instructions. So you already know that when we were discussing about different types of programs in your C and C++, we have lot many programs where we have written, right? Suppose if you take an example of a prime number or example of a Fibonacci series, whatever the programs you have written, so that contains a set of instructions, right? So a program contains a set of instructions. Then coming to a process is nothing but a program execution, right? So once a program is getting executed, then we call it as a process, right? So here we can take multiple tasks as a process. So first of all, we will discuss about the process states, right? So basically, a process is of two types. One is passive process and other one is a active process. Passive process is nothing but generally we try to read some instructions. Suppose you have written a program and given a program for your execution. So at that time your program will start from executing from the main memory, right? Then suppose after main memory you are having some variables like int a comma b, right? So that int a comma b is nothing but one instruction where it is a passive type. Okay, so now the instruction is executing. It's nothing but your process is getting executed. Right, suppose in your program you have a concept of for loop where we all know that for loop contains three things like first you are initialized, you are taking some variable like I and you are initializing that variable with 1 and you are checking the condition I less than or equal and then it is I plus plus. Okay, right, instead of 10 I will take some number. Okay, so here this is the condition where if this for loop is satisfying, then it has to execute something like you are asking to display some cout statement of I. Okay, so like this something if you are considering it. So what here it happens is like, so whenever we are taking this type of cases, right, now what happens is this, first you have a main memory instruction where we are reading that and then you are trying to read some variables. When coming to this loop, suppose if your program is having this for loop, so here first of all what does the compiler do? It tries to read the instructions. It's nothing but you are trying to execute the instructions where it is a passive type, right? So coming to this for loop, first it is checking that first it is going with I equals to 1 where it is initializing I value with 1 and then checking the condition whether 1 is less than or equals to 10. Yes, it is satisfied. So once it is satisfied, then the for loop has to be executed, right? So this is the process which we are taking in the for loop. Whenever you are executing this and then continuing this loop until and unless this instruction becomes false, that means the for loop gets false, until that time the instruction program will be executed, right? So where we say that it is nothing but an active process. Okay, so passive is like normally reading a program, where active process is like multiple times the same instructions you are trying to execute, right? So that comes under a active process. So one is passive process, another one is an active process, right? So next, a process is nothing but a programmer execution. Next, coming to the process stage, basically I would like to tell you like suppose a birth of a human being will be traveling in different ways till his death, right? So the birth of a human being's positions will be changed year by year, right? So based on some our age or anything, so we have to go through many of the stages, right, where we are trying to go through many of the states, right? So this is about the process states, right? Now coming to the process, a process is also having different states. One is new, ready, running, new, ready, running, about to be created, right? So here we have a transition. function diagram for this process state. One is new. So the new is nothing but where you are creating the process, right? So first, from this state the process is created, right? It is about to create. It's not ready for execution. It is just about to create. And next you have a ready state. Ready state. So here in this, whatever the process has been born, so that are ready for execution. Now all the process were scheduled in one place and they are ready for execution. Okay, so that is ready state. Here it is process. In the new state, it is the process being like just born. Okay, it is about to create. And coming to the ready state, the process was created and they were ready for execution. Okay, so whenever it is ready for execution, we move that process to the running state. So the process has moved to the running state. That means the process has assigned to the CPU. Right. So now the process, here you have a concept of scheduler, a dispatcher. Dispatcher is nothing but it is a software where it will dispatch a process from the ready queue to the running queue. Okay, so running state. So in this running state, now the next thing, suppose the process execution is done without any intervention, so the process execution work is finished, then the process will be moved to the terminated state. Terminated state. Okay, that means the process task is finished, then we are just removing. Right. Next, coming to the waiting state. Suppose here what happens is basically when we start using the different types of process, so here all the process were in use with some resources like input output resources, right? So whenever a process is in use with an input output operation, whenever a process is in use with an input output operation, so that time we will move on to the waiting state. Waiting what we can call as a block state. Okay, so waiting or a block state. So here, whenever we were discussing about this input output operation, once a task of this input output operation is finished, then it will move on to the ready state. Right, then it will be moving on to the ready state. So once the task of input output operation is done, then again the process is ready for the running state. Okay, so this is all about the process state. So first thing is new, that is about to create, like being created, you can say it as being created. And in the ready state, it is created. And coming to the running state, the process has assigned to the CPU for execution. And once the task of process is done successfully, then it has been given to the final stage, that is terminated state. Suppose if a process is used with any of the input output operations, like if you want any of the resources of an input output, so at that time the process will be available in a waiting state or a block state. Okay, so then after completion of input output operation completion, it will move on to the ready state. Okay, so here this is the task which we are trying to do under this process state. Apart from this, these are basically, generally we learn all these process states, right? So apart from these, here we have two more states. One is a suspend ready state and other one is a suspend block state. So first we will discuss about a suspend ready state. Suspend ready. So the name itself is telling that ready, it means that the process is being created. Suspend means you are trying to suspend some process, right? So what process you are trying to suspend, for what reason you are going to suspend it, right? So you can see that whenever we discuss about a ready queue, here all the process which are born from new state are ready for execution in this state. Right. So here in the ready queue, what it is happening? You have multiple processes which are given to the running state. Right. So here you have, suppose the main memory is less. Suppose the main memory size contains only, like you have, it can fit only 100 processes. Now this ready queue is ready with all the 100 processes. So later what happens is, once you have this 100 processes were ready within this ready queue, suppose immediately a new process has been created with higher priority, right? A new process is created with higher priority. So that has to be gone to the ready queue. But now for that process, there is no sufficient space in the ready queue. So at that time, we use one concept called suspend ready state, where here, whatever the process which are least priority when compared with the new process. Okay, so we are saying that this new process is ready, it is having highest priority. So immediately we have to wait for the running state. So at that time, what we are doing is, like the process, as the ready queue is not ending, so what we are doing, we are trying to suspend some process which are having least priority, that we are suspending to the suspend ready state. So after completion of this, once the task of this ready queue is finished, that means now we are giving an opportunity for the new process for execution, but the space is available. So for the new process we are trying to view, and then that process will be gone for running or whatever the next case. But coming to here, you are trying to suspend some process, and once the ready queue is empty, again you can resume to it. Okay, so the suspend ready, when do we use suspend ready state? We use whenever the ready queue is already filled, that means the main memory can fit only for some, like as you are having some space on the main memory, all the process were filled with the 100 process, suppose the ready queue is filled, then other process has been created which is having a highest priority other than this ready queue. Then from this, as the space is not available in the ready queue, here from this state we are suspending some process which are having least priority, that we are suspending and giving an opportunity for the highest priority of the process, and then it is giving to the run. So after, when the ready queue is empty, like some space is provided in that, at that time again you can resume it for the ready queue. Okay, so apart from that, I told you one more thing, it is there. Like, even though here you have one more block called suspend waiting. Okay, so why do you suspend here? The same reason. So whenever, when the process comes for an input output operation, so at that time, if any of the process is need an input output operation and the space is not sufficient for that, at that time from this wait also, from this state also, you are suspending some process, and when the space is available, then you are sending it to the waiting state. And don't think that it is not doing any work. Here also it is doing some work. The process were trying to perform this input output operation. Suppose here the process P1 is there, which is suspended from the waiting state, and it is performing its input output operations and completed its task. That means the process in input output operation work is completed, then it can directly go to the ready state. Okay, so it can directly go to the ready state. It can directly go to the suspend ready state. So from that again it will have an opportunity to the ready state. Okay, so this is all about the process states. Okay, so just as advice, first state is a process new state, that is the process is being created, and the ready state, it is ready for execution, that's the process is created and ready for execution. Okay, so coming to the running state, from the ready state, the dispatcher is dispatching the process to the CPU for execution. If the process is executed properly, then the process can be terminated. If the process is in use with any of the input output operations, then it can be in a waiting or a block state. Okay, so once the operation of this is finished, again it will move on to the ready state for execution. Okay,